My name is Nash Holson. I am a PMC, a private military contractor. At least, that's what they call us now. People used to call us mercenaries, guns for hire, soldier of fortune. Whatever they call us, the job always stays the same. When shit really hits a fan, and the military can't touch it, they give us a call. A commander team of four, been together for about 8 years, with dozens of missions all over the world, never lost a man. We live and die by our motto, no one left behind. These words are really important to us. Just like any soldiers, we know the risk of each mission. But we also know and trust each other with our lives every single day. That is until the day you wake up and you realize that you are in way over your head. And there is no one who can help you. This is our story.
Have a seat, Nash. Let's get down to business.
I'd like to introduce you to Muhammad Hassan, or T3 as the boys in D.C. call him. Number 3 on the Al-Qaeda most wanted list.
Very well trained, very difficult to track.
The CIA's been following this guy for 2 years. Every time they think they have him,
he just disappears. The man's a fucking ghost. He travels in small groups, often with women and children, to avoid airstrikes. We've currently got intel that he's leading a small force operating on the lower quadrant of Sector 4.
Sector 4, sir?
Why? Is that a problem?
It's a mess down there, sir. It's a red zone.
That's why they called us.
When do we leave?
ASAP. Get your team together.
Copy that.
Private military contracting has become a multi-billion dollar per year industry. The number of contractors continues to grow each year, operating missions throughout the world, providing transport, armed security, and protection. Services normally provided by uniformed soldiers. Currently, thousands of PMCs are on contract in the Middle East. During times of war, that number increases substantially. However, as the conflicts that help create the industry wind down, PMC organizations must adapt to survive, accepting missions beyond their normal services.
Commander Reynolds on deck.
I'm picking up a signal. It looks like we got some friends in Sector 4.
Sector 4?
We don't have anybody in Sector 4. We have guys over in Sector 5. 4 should be clear.
All right. What do you have for me?
Target 1. By the entrance. 3 plus down.
Target 1. 3 plus down.
I am showing something from that area, sir.
Those are our GPS signals. A team of 4? All right, let me contact I-Corps.
What's up?
Wind. 3 knots east-west.
Wind. 3 knots east-west.
There's no way we could be positive that it's our guys.
Target 2, 4 feet left to target 1.
Target 2 acquired.
This could be Al-Qaeda trying to throw us off. Understood, sir. Proceeding with the strike.
All right, boss. Ready for your call.
Steve, what's your location?
did with the house.
Thanks. I know I shouldn't spend the money, but I get lonely. He's gone for months at a time. I have to find some way to keep myself from going crazy.
You're going crazy? It's been over 3 months since Scott left. That's how long it's been.
Try living in the same house as your ex-husband and his son and see how great your sex life is.
Oh, no way.
I don't know. After this mission's over, I only want three things. Peace. Love. And sex.
Yeah, I love
that. This is so good, guys. Thanks, Mom.
اس کے لیے یہی ٹھیک ہے کہ ایک کتے کی موت مرے.
right, let's pump him up.
I have an update on Operation Michaela, sir.
Let's have it.
The enemy focused most of their strength in this
area during the attack.
Much higher numbers than we anticipated.
Okay, what about the target?
Unfortunately, the target escaped, sir.
What's the status of the contractors?
Yeah, we received a friendly GPS signal in the area. We had no way of knowing it was the contractors, so we proceeded with the airstrike. We lost all of them but one.
What the fuck just happened?
I just heard it myself. I don't know all the details yet.
No, the details are simple. You're in charge of the private fucking contractors.
And they got in the middle of a
fire zone when we launched an airstrike. We may have just killed our own men.
It'll be taken care of.
Knock would be more appropriate, if you don't mind.
Roger that. Where's Max?
He's at back playing. You know, he asks about you a lot. I'm running out of excuses. When are you going to stop blaming yourself for the past and start being a better father to your son? It's not too late for that, you know.
I'm working on it, okay?
Dad! Dad?
What is it?
Do you know that the Grand Canyon's over 6,000 feet deep, and over 20 football fields, and 277 miles long?
No, I didn't know that.
You didn't?
No!
But you said we can go to the Grand Canyon one day.
You know what? I know I promised you we'll go to the Grand Canyon. You know. But I'm telling you, I promise, okay?
Okay.
Oh, I love you, buddy. Come here.
Love you, Dad.
Thank you.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم من كتاب المجاهدين الأفغان إلى كلاب أمريكا. أيها الجبناء، أنتم تقاتلون من أجل المال، ونحن نقاتل من أجل الدفاع عن عرضنا وأرضنا وأهلنا. أيها الجبناء، هؤلاء رجالكم، سوف نقوم بذبحهم إذا أرسلتم لنا أي رجال الآخرين. سنقتلهم بإذن الله، والله معنا، وأنتم إلى الجحيم.
You have a phone call, boss.
Thank you, Jacob. Nash?
Sir, I just received an email. I don't know from who. It's a video, sir.
Excuse me?
They are alive, sir.
I see. And what exactly would you like us to do about it?
We need to get them out, sir. We don't have much time.
If Michaela was classified, there's no way we can go back now.
So you're telling me you know my men are alive and you're not going to do anything about it, right?
Hey, you know what you're getting into every time you accept a mission. That's a life you chose. That's why you're making the big bucks, pal.
No one gets left behind, sir.
You're not soldiers, you're mercenaries. No one cares about a team of hired guns getting stuck behind enemy lines.
You know what? The more I think back to that mission, the airstrikes, the men that were not supposed to be there, the more I think you're covering up something, sir.
I'm sorry, Nash, there's nothing I can do. He's going back.
This is Aisha Nasser, reporting live from the Afghanistan-Pakistan border, a region now referred to as Sector 4. It is believed that many of the top Al-Qaeda leaders are operating out of this area. Recently, the government deemed Sector 4 to be a red zone, an area too unsafe to orchestrate ground assaults by U.S. troops, making many of the top Al-Qaeda leaders seemingly untouchable by the U.S. troops. This is Aisha Nasser reporting live from Sector 4. Back to you.
Come on!
fuck are you looking at? You all right?
Buddy.
Yeah. Come on.
Doing all right?
I can't take this anymore. We're getting out of here.
They're not gonna get out of here.
Yeah.
We're gonna wait.
I'm done waiting.
Now she'll be here. You'll see.
You know, in the war days, I was in the same situation. I lost some of my unit's friends. They were left behind. But I was told to stand down. I did. Not a day goes by I don't think about those faces or see them. If you're gonna go to one of the craziest parts of the world, the most dangerous, you're gonna have to fight the people, the elements, the weather, the desert, the snow, skydive, by yourself. You need to get mentally strong so you can survive and see your kid. Make sure you say goodnight to him.
Let's do it.
We gotta get the fuck out of here.
How are we supposed to be gonna get the fuck out of here?
We've been a team for how long? How long? Our wives hanging out together. We're a team.
Yeah, it's not gonna leave anybody behind.
I feel pretty fucking abandoned. Been, what, 70-some fucking days in here? Ain't no one coming for us.
He's gonna come for us.
He's gonna be here. Just trust. Trust, he'll be here.
That's gonna get you killed.
We're gonna get killed anyway. At least this is gonna be my way. My kids are not gonna watch their dad have his head cut off and watch it on TV.
Nash will be here. He'll be here. You'll see. He'll be here. You just gotta stand down, be a little stronger.
You're going back, aren't you?
Yep.
Yeah. I actually thought this time was gonna be different. For the first time, I believed that you were gonna change things and be a better father to Max.
I can't leave them behind.
Not Max. You're leaving him behind. All this week he's been talking about the trip that you two were supposed to take to the Grand Canyon. That should be your priority. Jesus, Nash. I know you could care less what happened between us. Lord knows I'm over it. I really love those guys too. But a real man, a good father, knows when to turn his back and let somebody else take care of the problem.
There is nobody else.
You're just trying to play hero so you can feel better about yourself. Meanwhile, I'm taking care of Max, not knowing if you're coming back. Which is why I divorced you. We live in the same house. And I'm okay with that. But don't go out and get yourself killed. Your son needs you. More than anyone.
I promise I'll be back. Promise.
Dear Max, I want you to remember how much I love you. I promise that when I return, we'll go to the Grand Canyon and visit all the places that you can't imagine. I miss you already. And I love you. Love. Dad.
Shalom. You ready?
Shalom.
You know I can't teach you how to fight, but I can teach you how to survive so you can come back. Let's go.
Aloha.
Hey, Christoph. This is Charlie. How are you doing, man?
Charlie, my friend, how are you? Very, very, very busy, very busy. Haven't spoke to you in ages. Last time I heard you were dead.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, buddy, I'm not dead yet. Allison,
I'm gonna go on a little vacation pretty soon.
I'm gonna need a couple things.
Vacation, huh? Are you going to visit your old friends from last trip?
How do you know about that?
Facebook, what do you think?
So, when are you playing this trip of yours?
Very soon.
No problem, no problem. Anything you want.
Make sure you take care of me, okay? Not like last time, okay? Don't screw it up.
Charlie, come on, really?
Of course, no.
Make sure you say hi to the wives.
I'm honest Russian man. Yes, poor.
Yak. All right, just take care of me, all right?
No problem.
All right, thanks, I appreciate that.
All right, I'll see you soon, okay?
Bye. Ciao.
सब मरने के लिए तैयार हो
ना
जिहाद के लिए अपने मुल्क के लिए अपने खुदा के लिए जान दोगे ना
अच्छा जी
अच्छी बात है जो भी आएगा हम पे हमला करेगा हम उनको मार देंगे
ठीक है
इंशाल्लाह और अपने मुल्क का दिफा करोगे और अपनी बीवियों का अपनी बेटियों का और अपने भाइयों का दिफा करोगे ठीक है
बिल्कुल
इंशाल्लाह
इंशाल्लाह
आप के लिए तैयार हो चलो चले
यल्ला
इट्स अ पार्ट
यल्ला
Stand by. Good.
Copy that. Stand by.
Good!
شلون اقرب هذيك الطرف؟
ناخذ طريق الوادي.
اطلع ورايا، حناخذ طريق الوادي.
اصبر افتح.
Спасибо.
So, you want to buy some firearms, right? Have amazing guns for you, my friend.
Love Americans so much, especially your money.
So, you ready?
Oh my God, breathtaking, breathtaking.
Ba-dum!
Look at this, baby. Mwah! Yeah. Brand new weapon, very good in combat. Quite pricey though, very expensive model.
What about that one? How much for that one?
Oh, my friend, that one.
This one. A very good gun.
I'll get you amazing deal. 500 Americans. Great price for amazing gun.
What about I give you $200 for the rifle, I give you $200 for the handgun, and $100 for the ammo. How's that?
Good? Son of a bitch, my friend. What about it? I'll cut your throat when you sleep. Sounds good.
Got a deal?
We got a deal.
Right.
Euros or pound sterling?
Do you take credit cards?
Credit cards? Are you kidding me? Credit cards. You, можно сказать, in a desert. And you want a credit card. Cash, my friend. Only cash. Military cages were buried all along this area. Come here, come here. I'll show you. These numbers. Mm-hmm. 60 degrees up, up and west. And you can get whatever you want there. So many explosives. Wow.
Here's for you.
How do I get there, though? I need a car, so...
Boy, I have no cars. No cars.
My cousin, Tolia, is a fucking great car dealer. He has amazing cars, so good cars, and great super cheap prices for you. And I'm gonna call them, because I care about my customers, and you're my favorite, my best friend, even more. And he's gonna give you a discount. He's gonna come here for you. Come right here for you, deliver a car, the one you want. You enjoy the weather, mountains, I give you sun lotion even, so you can enjoy yourself. All right? And he's gonna come here and sell you cars, right? Amazing? Oh, my friend. Pleasure doing business with you. Pleasure.
Sure.
My best friend.
Здравствуйте. Вы говорите по-русски?
Я говорю little по-русски. English.
My cousins do not speak English, but I do. They never let me hang out with them when they're doing their business. They say I'm too young. But they let me come today because I learned English in school.
Huh. Nice of them. So, listen, I have a long drive. You think this car is going to take me to where I want to go?
Как работает?
Работает как часы.
He says it works like clockwork.
Okay. Clockwork?
Yes, clockwork.
Good. Listen, Christoph told me $200.
Сколько стоит?
Ты спроси у него, сколько у него денег на кармане.
Блин. He says, they want to know how much you have in your wallet.
How much I have in my wallet?
Yes.
Oh boy, I guess a deal is not a deal.
The man who sent you, Krzysztof, they tell me he owes them a lot of money. Since you're his friend, they want to take it from you.
Well, first of all, I'm not his friend. And secondly, I just have $200.
Он скажет, что не друга Крызештова.
Слышь, у нас это волнует, блин.
И то же, что у него только $200.
А что за ложков нас держит?
Нас это что, волнует, блядь? Друг он, не друг, блядь.
They have little time.
Yep.
Давай с ним как-то завершать,
блядь. Опа! Америка, Европа, нарвался лошок, бабло! Бабло, я сказал!
Во-во-во, братан, братон, да ты чё? Да ты раз и так делал, слушай, бать, ну чё?
Давай, мы-то, братуха, мы так не ролаем, ты знаешь? Так у нас не идет.
А, твой мать.
Check the safety, asshole. Get in the car.
Повезло,
get in the car.
Повезло,
get the fuck out of here, найдем. Bitch. वीडियो कैमरा तैयार करो इस बहन चोट को आज ही खत्म करेंगे हम जाओ
सही
तुम्हारे मुल्क ने भेजा है इस आदमी को मेरा कत्ल करने के लिए हमारे ईमान का कत्ल करने के लिए लेकिन अब देखो इसको कुत्ते की तरह भीख मांग रहा है अपनी जिंदगी की हम इसका भी यही हशर करेंगे जो बाकी सबका किया है अल्लाह हू अकबर
अल्लाह अकबर
जिहाद फी सबीलिल्लाह
सलाम अलैकुम दिस इज आयशा नासर रिपोर्टिंग लाइव फ्रॉम द अफगानिस्तान पाकिस्तान बॉर्डर Information regarding the recent attack on the Afghanistan-Pakistan border has just been released earlier today. It is believed that following the attack, three private US military contractors have been held hostage by an Al-Qaeda group operating in the area, led by Mohammed Ahsan, number three on the most wanted list. No demands have been issued at this time. This marks the fourth instance in which several contractors have been involved in the Red Zone area in Afghanistan. Previous instances left several contractors Reporting back to you.
Thank you.
have some intel for you regarding Sector 4.
About your captive men?
Not exactly. It's about the one that got out. He's going back.
After what happened with that last mission, you're going to send someone back?
And on government funds, no less?
No, we didn't orchestrate this at all. He's doing it on his own.
And why would he do that?
Yeah, no one left behind. I think that's the phrase he used.
A mercenary that gives a fuck. Great.
If your intel on Bin Laden is correct, you may be privy to his location.
So what are you telling me for?
I'm just waiting for the right moment to strike, a diversion, a hole in their security.
Oh, I can
personally guarantee that once Nash is in the area, a real shitstorm is gonna start.
I want you to keep me informed on every move Nash makes. Every move he makes, you keep me
posted.
Understood.
About it.
Whoa, okay, easy.
Won't find anything there anyway.
Who the fuck are you?
Daniels.
Jones.
Paulson.
Fuck you guys. Scared the shit out of me.
Reynolds gave us intel you'd be coming out here. Didn't expect to see you so soon.
Got out here pretty quick for a private military contractor.
Three of us have been out here the past 4 months tracking number three.
We hear you created quite the shitstorm a few months back going after number three.
There were four. One of us was compromised. Heard the screams, but we never found the body.
If you're looking for weapons and explosives, this is where you'll find them. I hope you like to swim. We hear you're going back after your boys.
It's a suicide mission. You know that.
Any intel?
Yeah, about 15, 20 strong. Packed up the village a couple hours ago. Heading to the hideout. It's marked on your map.
Good luck.
Let's have it.
Sir, Nash just made contact with Delta, and the map's been delivered. He's on track, just as we were anticipating, heading straight for the cache. His ETA to final destination is 48 hours. If he survives.
Don't forget, come back alive to your son.
Так я собак потихоньку.
Чай.
Что не можешь дыхать? Дыху вас!
يا حسن روح المنطقة اللي هناك، احنا هنأمن المنطقة دي. لا 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 لا، شمال شمال شوية شمال. ايوه هناك.
هذا زوج اختي، شكله غبي ها.
Yeah, I should go back.
هي تشيرسي.
هي تعال هون.
تشيرسي.
شو بتعمل هنا؟
تشيرسي.
مين انت؟
سوسوكي. انت سيكي
اللي بدك.
انت سيكي يا مايك. انت امريكاني؟
امريكاني.
انت امريكاني.
Guys, it's me. Get the guns. Pick up the weapons. Get the weapons.
What happened to Scott?
They killed him.
Salaam alaikum. This is Aisha Nasser reporting live once again from the Afghanistan-Pakistan border. As conflict continues to rise in the Middle East, the whereabouts of Osama bin Laden are still unknown. However, drone surveillance has shown heavy activity near the Afghanistan-Pakistan border, AKA Sector 4, which the government has recently deemed too dangerous to engage in combat, causing a stalemate in the war on Balkhide. This is Aisha Nasser, reporting back to you.
Hey. Thank you. For me and my family. Thank you.
You're welcome, buddy. That you have done the same thing for me.
I would have tried.
Wait, okay. This is Kabul. You got the grid? Hey, then, did you copy that?
Yeah, it's about
1,030
miles.
How's your name?
Guess our recommendation? Nash traveled to Sector 4 via civilian means and began a large ground assault on Al-Qaeda forces in the area. We had no such good contact, but he has to believe that both Nash and the hostages are unfortunately DEAD.
Hold on, Nash.
Morning, sir. Gone with the reporter. Can't wait to hear what happened next. Gone.
It is good to see you, Nash.
Is it?
So, how are the men?
I got Steven out. Brad and Scott are dead, but I'm sure you already know that, don't you, sir?
Sorry about that, Nash. Really, I am. But like I said, that's why you guys make the big bucks, right? You risk it all.
You're the one who sent me that video. You knew Bin Laden location, knowing that we'd go back in Sector 4, create enough chaos so it would open the window for the military to move in on Bin Laden. Am I correct, sir?
With less forces protecting Bin Laden, the better chance we had to take him out with safety to our men.
What about my men? You used them as bait. You sent us on a suicide mission, sir. The only problem is I am still alive.
Men like us don't operate on nobility and honor, so don't bullshit with some hero act. War has become a very lucrative business and made me a very rich man. So how much will it take?
Nothing is going to change anyway. So I want a proper military service for my two men. That's number one. Number two, I want a big check, and I mean a big one. And number three, I want out for good, sir.
I'll miss you. Okay, here we go. That'll buy your kid a nice, shiny new bike.
It's not only for me, sir.
I'm sorry to hear that, Nash. I had a job lined up you'd be the perfect man for.
I'm sure you did. I already got a job, sir. Thank you.
No one left behind. We live and die by those words. Turns out maybe we didn't understand what that meant. Who was actually being left behind? Many soldiers lose their lives to save others. Not everyone understands why they do it. Sometimes, not even their own family, because they are the ones left behind. The ones that have to deal with the loss and the pain. But now, I'm making the same promise to you and Max, to never leave you behind again.